think about it. I go, he's asking me all different types of things. Oh, what would you do to remote the control? Sunsoft has never been one for sound.
Seven is really good, actually. You hear the voice. You're not gonna get that me on that one 50 times in a row.
That game was awesome.
What is it?
That game I was playing on the computer over there, where I was sitting down. He goes, you wanna try it on the headset? I go, you have a headset? He goes, yeah, he puts it on. I'm like, oh! I could feel my head going back and forth too. I was like, oh god. He goes, you got the farthest out of anybody. I go, yeah, well. Total, or are there gonna be more?
Yeah, it's gonna be total right there. Superman, Hero.
got two characters done.
Did you see that over there in the video game? Basketball using
Wow. This is gonna be awesome.
Yeah. years from compression technologies, and so we're able to achieve a 640 by 320 full resolution at 30 frames a second without benefit of special hardware, and it's streaming off the CD-ROM drive. It's not cached to the hard drive.
Which speed CD-ROM drive?
Double speed.
And so what's the base spec on the CPU?
Base spec is 486, and I'm not sure if we want it. 166, but I'm not sure.
Okay.
It'll run slower, but if the processor's not keeping up, it'll skip frames, so you won't get the full flowing motion.
So do you have a partition on the hard drive? Do you load anything onto the hard drive at all? Or?
Yeah, we load drivers and...
But it's not like a big partition?
Right, no, it's not. This is all, everything's coming off of the... The game is going to load probably a large partition. But this is streaming off of the drop, off of the CD-ROM.
Yeah,
Grant
is like, I'm planning on using this small, maybe 5 megabyte swap space.
5 meg swap space, maybe.
Compression is at such a state, though, that you're really not worried about large amounts of drive space. Right now, it's 10.6, but you have a high tolerance for products. Yeah. I think Graham still was planning on
Is this more, is there more navigation in the $11 than there is in the 7th guest?
Use your hook on the left side.
for 25 years.
A mic.
Thank you.
Stewart.
Shrunk back, I gave him the reasons. Because the first one was black, a lot of game frame rolls. Right? can get the feeling in there very well.
They really need to.
I am a mom.
I've got 16 systems and a computer, so.
And you like games?
Yeah.
Oh, jeez, yeah.
Do you do? Is he just saying yes to you, or does he
also? No, I play them all the time. I really got into that headset. I loved it. With that headset there? Oh, that was great.
Yeah, if you only had something just to sit in, you know?
I could build one.
No, no.
I'm back.
Pretty easy.
I was thinking about it, but I don't have any room.
I do.
Thank you.
version because they renamed it Redline Racer.
Yeah.
Acceleration, A. To change perspective, use the number keys.
Which one?
The number keys, like 5 is the farthest away. Oop, wrong way. Your break.
You want to see consuming engine even more completed? Think about the big screen over there. Oh, Michael.
Thank you. and he's looking at his stuff. Sent me a videotape of Super Star Wars before the old Genesis version.
Ooh. Keep in mind, we're looking at stuff that represents things that are.
Yeah, I know.
You know, only 10%, 20% in the development.
I want better sound.
Where's a typhoid?
Do you mind if a friend of mine comes in here?
Who's your friend?
It's just a guy that I work with, but he doesn't have his actual press badge with him. Oh, hi. Him.
Okay.
John's not here yet.
No, he's not? Okay. The guy outside told me to come on.
Oh.
I thought, okay. What else do they have for this here?
Metalhead, this, and Virtua Racing Deluxe.
Can you put in Virtua Racing Deluxe?
Well, let him show me this for a while. It's nice enough to show it.
Hey, how's it going?
Just fine.
Can we get some direct feed off the X?
Into what?
Into this. I see you got a video going into the TV.
Let's see. Okay. Probably,
play it on the limited
not
TV.
Right now.
All
right.
So right now.
You gotta keep in mind you're looking at stuff that's probably only, that's really only about 10 to 20% into development.
Yeah.
That's what we have of Star Wars so far.
Yeah.
I'm using the title screen.
Is this your wife?
No.
We can all imagine what the soundtrack will be like.
Oh, it'll be wonderful and stupendous. It'll be awesome. You'll be amazing.
Sell that product.
Yes.
Do you want more?
Looks sweet though. It's like X-Wing.
Better graphics.
I call it the best, man.
I just offered her a brand new one, unopened.
It was an afterthought.
Sonic!
Ah!
I like the sound.
Ah, yeah, got that done. Right. So what'd you say, about 20, 30% done?
This?
They are going to downsize.
No, this is only 10% done.
It's huge, 10% like, portable refrigerator.
Yeah. There's a lot that's going to be
happening. Well, your Genesis can handle that. It's made out of high-grade plastic.
There's a lot that's going to be happening over the next month. Because of the way the machine works, bringing the coin op in is actually pretty easy. So a lot happens very quickly. This is what we have to show right now. We also have things where, you know, because we're running them on development systems, some of the games don't want to run unless there's like a PC hooked up to them or a special debugger, because, you know, programmers are working on them right now. And so we only brought the games that we could actually run off of cartridges at the time.
So that's the motor game and this one?
Yeah. And even then, the stuff that's running off of cartridge may not represent how far the game actually is.
No, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. And right now, actually, almost all the games are only using one of the SH2 RISC processors. We haven't started what we do is we get the game going with one of the processors. Oh, well, that's what it's really going to look like.
Yeah.
Okay, this is what the robots will really look like in the final game. Right now we've just got some placeholder flat polygon, not even with shading, artwork in here. And the backgrounds are still pretty crude. They're texture mapped, but the textures are pretty boring and not very colorful right now, so...
And it seems the polygons aren't really interacting well yet.
Nah, they're not sorting too well right now. Like I said, it's a placeholder.
Yeah.
And really, the view isn't going to be like... There's multiple views, just like Virtua Racing. There's four points of view. First person, kind of a first person just behind him the way you saw it before.
Now, is this going to be an arcade game, too?
And one even further.
Is this going to be an arcade game they're doing, or...?
Well, the team that did Virtua Racing Arcade is actually doing this game.
Okay.
And there's nothing preventing us from taking it to arcade, but if we did, almost certainly we'd use the Daytona hardware to do it. And, or the Titan. Yeah, either one. Maybe Titan, it's cheaper.
More arcades would carry it then.
Any chances of Virtua Fighters coming out for the 32X?
I'm sorry, but you know, I'm not allowed to comment on anything but Star Wars and Virtua Racing.
Just say yes.
I can't even say yes or no. I can't say anything.
Do you know
that? I can't even say I can neither confirm nor deny. We're real sensitive about coin-op games, and so we're not supposed to talk about any of the coin-op games unless we're told we can talk about them.
God knows, magazines just really...
So I'm surprised you guys don't have any type of Saturn demo, because they even have one in Japan that they showed on TV.
Well,
I got to see it.
Saturn's being released this Christmas in Japan.
Yeah.
But,
it's not going to be out here for...
Well, here in the United States, there's 13 million Genesis owners.
Yeah.
And the Genesis is going like gangbusters, and there's no reason for us to come out with anything new other than the 32X, which gloms onto the Genesis anytime soon at all. And I mean, our goal in the future is that the 32X will be, the 32X is really the future of where the Genesis is, and it's an upgrade path in the 32 bits for the Genesis. And in the future, at some date down the road, you'll probably see a world where we have a lineup of the lower end 32-bit system being the 32X, and a higher end system, probably Saturn. And so people who want to get into 32-bit now and want to have a 32-bit system for the next 2 to 3 years, the 32X is the place to go. They don't lose their old Genesis games. They get a full 32-bit system, and they get it for under $150 instead of $500. You know, and with it's a bird's life or something. You know, real spectacular software.
We have to make sure that
Virtua is really finicky right now.
Oh, really?
Necessarily want to come up first time. Well, like I said, we're taking games that are, you know, kind of early in their development cycle.
Okay.
And telling the programmers, okay, put it on a cartridge, and they're like, what? I don't know if it'll work on the cartridge.
Oh, wow. That's a lot smoother.
Actually, the car itself is actually identical to the coin-op version.
Yeah.
The tracks right now only have half as many polygons as they're going to have when we're done, and they don't like source shade. So once again, the light source shading is double the number of polys in the track. And we're not really, and the colors of the track really aren't as diverse as we want them to be yet.
Yeah. So what you're looking at is really like pretty crude compared to what it's going to be.
Is this just basically the Genesis track then?
Right. The track is the same as the one on the Genesis, but the car is the coin-op car.
Right.
And we'll have the new tracks will be twice as complex and have shading and much better use of the colors, more colors in them actually.
How's a cockpit view look?
I don't have that in right now.
We only have three views in right now.
We have this view, which is the first person to move. That view, and the long shot.
Okay.
It's so much smoother with the additional color.
Hey, want to play?
It's so much better.
Feel free.
Oh, that's no thanks.
Well, here, I'll play it.
Good. B is accelerate. Is the accelerator.
It's already on, so this.
B is accelerate, A is brake, and various and sundry buttons change the view. And sometimes I think it's in manual shifting right now. Sometimes if you tap on B, it goes faster. The programmer wasn't exactly clear with me on how I actually change gears or accelerate. And again, right now we're still only using one of the SH2s in this. So once we split the math out and have it on the other processor, and we're probably going to get it up another 10 frames a second of additional speed.
It's not tweaked for gameplay.
And that background right there is going to be replaced. That's a 16 color background. That'll be replaced with a full 256 color background.
The only thing that still gets me about this, it looks a lot smoother still, but like on the car, mm-hmm. you can still see how it's kind of jagged.
Uh-huh. Is that ever going to get fixed, or is that just
something that's
systems,
holding it back?
The development systems have a really video output on them right now.
Because, I mean, I've got a Super VHS TV, and I put, like, Castlevania or any, like, virtual racing on my TV, and it looks like really crap.
Yeah, these development systems have really crummy video, and the colors aren't balanced here correctly.
Yeah.
You can see the whites are just too brilliant. And, I mean, right now there's 256 colors, but they're not using them all right now. It's like, this is very early in development.
This already looks a lot better than Genesis. It looks a lot smoother and everything else. Yeah. I mean, just like the bridges and everything, the color just doesn't look right. And John kept telling me that the 32X was going to fix all that. I was like, God, I hope so. Because that new TV really kind of, it shows every flaw in any game I have on any system. I got a 27-inch TV with 700 lines of resolution. I mean,
need a cheaper TV.
Yeah,
it actually didn't only cost me about $400.
Wow!
Wow!
Where'd you get them?
Best Buy.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Cool.
You definitely really got it.
I don't know.
Two Super VHS inputs and everything.
I think I'm gonna move up to a big screen TV. I've got a 27-inch now. It's just not big enough.
Nice.
Sharp vision is nice.
I want to get like a 50-inch projection screen TV.
I need my TV to be my wall.
Than I usually do.
I played the Genesis one. And
there's a lot not here. I mean, the speedometer isn't there. There's track information that's not there.
This is pre-first
playable. Like I said, this is really just,
just a demo.
15%. You know, it's only one of the tracks. We're going to have a total of 6 tracks, 3 new ones, and 2 new cars.
Well.
Yep.
Next. When the arcade first came out,